What does the electrocardiogram show in women that are having a heart attack?
So, actually, in both men and women, sometimes we see big changes on the EKG that say we have to go right to the cath lab and open up the artery. But oftentimes, there are not changes on the EKG. Oftentimes, we don't see those big changes, when in fact, something can be seriously wrong.
So, what is the difference in men and women? Is it other parts of the heart or the muscle? What's going on?
So, oftentimes, we talk about microvascular disease.
Microvascular, that means small vessels.
Small vessels, things that are difficult to see during routine cardiac catheterization, things that we don't see on the angiogram.
So we can see the coronary vessels, those big ones, but this is down in the
This
muscle.
is down deep in the muscle. Those big arteries give little branches that dive deep into the muscle, and we cannot necessarily see with the naked eye what is going on with those vessels.
And there's a bigger problem there in that part in women than men.
Women, off more than men, women will have microvascular changes that can lead to chest pain, symptoms of heart disease, or heart attacks.
So, how do you handle microvascular cardiac disease?
That's a great question. We're learning. We don't really know the exact answer. Obviously, we want to treat women as we would men with heart attacks and with heart disease, but if we can't see those changes, sometimes they don't get diagnosed appropriately.
Especially if you may not see them on electrocardiogram, the normal, are there blood tests that say, hey, something's going on with the muscles in the heart?
Right, so there are blood tests that can indicate that a heart attack has happened, and for whatever reason, we don't see those changes on the angiogram, but we still need to treat those women as if they've had a heart attack, and that's where some of the discrepancy comes from.